The visitor brochures call Jefferson the B&B capital of Texas. But what they don't advertise is its other well-known title.
The most haunted small town in Texas.
I'm scared already.
Now, as you can imagine, every old home in Jefferson has its stories, but none is believed to be more haunted than this one right here. Welcome to the Grove. Let's take a tour, shall we?
Built in 1861 as a wedding gift for Frank and Minerva Stilley, the Grove gets its name from the towering pecans that shade the home in shadow and mystery.
Okay, so this is Mitchell Whittington, the man who lives in the most haunted home in Jefferson.
Well, that's what they say.
Man, this must be a trip of a place to live.
It's interesting. I have to say, I never would have anticipated this in my life. But it's not scary. It's not like living in the Addams Family house. It's really an interesting place because it's kind of like a little peek into the other side.
With many rooms furnished in period decor, the Grove is haunting enough without stories. But Mitchell's room-by-room tour brings the Grove to life. Or death. Brings it to death.
This was once the master bedroom to the house. We have had some activity in this room that's interesting. The first is probably one of our most famous spirits called the Lady in White. My favorite story about her comes from when this house was a restaurant in 1990, and they were doing dinner theater one night. The lighting tech had her lighting board set up on the front porch so it wouldn't take up space in the dining room. She looked over, she saw a lady in a long white dress walking beside the house here. And she assumed it was one of the actresses, so she hollered at her. She goes, "Excuse me, there's no door on that side of the house. You're going the wrong way." The woman just kept walking, so she leaned over the railing and she, you know, saw her going down to this part of the house. The lady turned and took a left and stepped up through a wall of the house. And I've seen her several times, as is my wife.
That's what I was gonna ask, yeah.
A lot of people have seen her throughout the years. You look back to the original construction of the house, with this being the back, it's probably that she's not stepping up through a wall. It's probably more that she's stepping up onto a back porch.
Back porch. Yeah,
coming
yeah.
through a wall that, or a door in the wall that would have been here and coming across there.
But the Lady in White, or in this case, the badly costumed man Lady in White, is just one of the Grove's many visitors.
We had one of the former owners, Charlie Young, the barber, come back and visit. He came back to visit the daughter of a friend of ours. And she starts describing a very distinguished looking African-American gentleman. And at one point, Tammy turned around and said, "Did he look anything like this?" And she goes, "That's the guy. He was here."
Oh, wow.
I said, "Kinsey, that's Mr. Charlie, the barber. He died in the 1930s. She saw a ghost." And I thought, wow, that's a great story.
Yeah.
These are just a few of the almost countless stories. And while we haven't had a personal experience yet, no visitor is safe.
We also have had a lot of things happen on the tour in here. We've had people get tapped on the shoulder and poked in the side. We had a group of us were all standing around. I was telling some of these stories one day. All of a sudden, the lady squealed and jumped about a foot in the air. You know, bah! You know, startled all of us. I was like, "Are you okay?" And she said, "We're all just standing around, you know, listening." All of a sudden, I felt somebody pop me on the bottom. She said, and I looked, and my husband's across the room, and I thought, "It's one of these strangers. One of these strangers has touched my bottom." She goes, "Boy, I was going to slap somebody silly." Yeah. But I looked, and nobody was near me. I said, "I am so sorry."
But to Mitchell and his wife, Tammy, ghostly experiences are just part of everyday life.
It was getting late, and we're both trying to finish a chapter in the books that we're reading so we could turn in. And as we're sitting there reading, suddenly the light goes click, turned itself off. So I found it, and click, turned it back on. I was like, "But you guys stop that," you know, and that is.
As you can imagine, living in the Grove has given Mitchell a very interesting perspective on life and the afterlife.
After living here for 10 years, what I've come to believe is that what we have are former owners coming back because they love the place so much, just to check on. And I understand that because the Grove has become part of my heart and soul, and I plan on coming back after I'm gone.
So 100 years from now, people see a man with long hair and a beard.
Probably on the front porch. I love that rocking chair.
Oh, yeah.
I love sitting out there early in the morning with a cup of coffee. So whoever lives here 100 years from now, talk about the rocking chair ghost, how that chair slowly starts rocking. You smell a coffee in the air, and that'll be me.
That's you. Yeah.
As nice as Mitchell is, ain't no way I'd ever be his roommate. To see the full episode or to get info about how to visit this spot, trip on over to thedaytripper.com.